Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, my dear student. This is your time to study, even though it is the first time of coming to your learning English wajib in 11 class, grade 11 for IBE 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and also grade 11 IBS 1, 2, 3, and 4. Let me explain you that I do hope you are always in best condition and of course in happy situation with studying. Dear student, me, your teacher, Ibu Siti Mariam, and also Ibu Asih Triwulan SPD, will give you the first material of the second semester. Here is personal letter. Before starting our learning today, would you start by praying first? Let's pray together. Start.
Amin. Alamin. Thank you, student. Finish your praying. Okay, we start our lesson today by having personal letter. Even though it is in COVID situation and it is in the first day of your learning, English will always give you your material. And we do hope you are in relaxed and good condition in thinking. Best condition in studying, and of course, I would like you to understand much about this material subject. Yeah. Let's continue to the next slide. Yeah, firstly, I give you the definition first for the personal letter. Of course, as a letter, you know well that letter means surat. So, personal letter. Letter here defined as a letter is a written message conveyed from one or a group of people to another through a medium. It can be formal or informal one. It is as a means of a communication and a store of information in written, of course. Yeah. While the personal letter, of course, defined as follows. Personal letters is a type of letter or informal composition that usually concerns personal matters and it is sent from one individual to another and it is longer than a dash of note or an invitation, which is usually handwritten and sent through the mail. Sorry, this written is through, not the, but through. Means melalui. Yeah, we continue. The social function of this letter is, of course, to inform that a receiver, that sender, wants to tell an important things like personal feelings, thoughts, or experiences which are meant to be read by a specific person. Social function here. The social function of personal letter is to inform that a receiver, that the sender wants to tell an important thing like personal feelings, thoughts, or experiences which are meant to be read by a specific person. Anak-anak, fungsi sosial atau tujuan teks dari personal letter itu adalah memberikan informasi bahwa sang penerima dan bahwa sang pengirim ingin menyampaikan atau menceritakan tentang sebuah informasi penting atau sesuatu hal yang dianggap penting, like personal feeling, seperti perasaan pribadi, pemikiran-pemikiran pribadi, atau pengalaman-pengalaman pribadi, which are means to be read, yang dimaksudkan untuk dibaca by a specific person, oleh sasaran tertentu atau seseorang yang menerima pesan tersebut. Yeah, let's write a letter. Yeah, form of a personal letter or structure. Apa sih yang terdapat di dalam personal letter itu sendiri? Di antaranya adalah date. This is the date when the letter is written. Tanggal di mana surat itu ditulis, kapan di surat itu ditulis, ya. Lalu name, address, yaitu CT or zip code, ya, yaitu ini adalah nama, alamat, kota atau kode tertentu yang dimiliki oleh pengirim. Salutation and name of recipient. Salutation di situ yang dimaksudkan adalah salam pembuka surat, and name of recipient yang diawali dengan nama penerima terkadang, atau hanya dear sir seperti itu misalnya, ya. The greeting usually starts with the words dear, to, on, etc. Ya. Dear followed by the given name yang diikuti oleh nama penerima of the recipients. Or relationship atau hubungan yang lain, and it's end with a comma, dan biasanya diakhiri oleh koma, ya. Two example are shown. Dua contoh di sini misalnya, dear Ronald, dear uncle, ya. Ronald adalah nama seseorang, uncle adalah panggilan dari orang yang menjadi saudara dari ayah atau ibu kita untuk laki-laki, atau contoh yang lain, dear sir, dear mom, ya, dear Santi, to Santi, and etc. Ya. Hi, hello, assalamualaikum, and etc. You can get it. Hi guys, like this. This is for personal letter. This will be decided, include in the age, and then whom gets the letter, yes, yang menerima surat itu siapa, and then next 1, 2, 3, date 1, name, address itu 2, salutation and name of recipient itu 3, and then introduction, this will be pengenalan, this opening of letter, meskipun sudah kenal tapi ada kata-kata basa basi. It may include greeting like how are you. Sometimes you may refer to a previous letter, ya, kadang-kadang ini ditempatkan di awal surat, ya. And then body of letters, ini adalah isi surat, ya, tubuh surat, pengenalan, basa basi, lalu tubuh surat, ya. This is the main part of the letter. It is includes the message that the writer wants to tell the recipients. Jadi maksudnya, it includes the message, ini mengandung pesan yang dimaksudkan oleh pengirim kepada pembacanya atau penerimanya. That the writer want to tell to the recipient, yang ingin dikatakan oleh penulis kepada penerimanya. It is often divided into paragraphs, dan ini biasanya terbagi atas paragraf-paragraf kalau suratnya agak panjang, karena ini dikatakan lebih panjang daripada desk of note, atau lebih panjang juga daripada invitation atau undangan, begitu. Undangan atau desk of note itu lebih pendek, ya. Next, closure. This part indicates the letter is going to end. The writer may ask the recipient to reply here. Jadi yang dimasukkan dengan closure di sini adalah bagian yang menunjukkan kepada penerima surat bahwa surat ini is going to end, akan berakhir. The writer may ask the recipient to reply here. Harapan untuk dibalas, permohonan, maaf, ucapan terima kasih masuknya adalah di closure. Lalu complimentary close. This such experience includes a few words in one line. It is end with a comma. Some examples are shown below. Yours sincerely. Sincerely yours. Best regards. Love. Ya. Contohnya itu. Jadi, yang terhormat, yang tertanda, yang bertanda tangan di bawah ini, dan sebagainya itu termasuk complimentary clause. Ya. Jadi, menunjukkan siapa nanti di bawahnya yang tanda tangan di signature, lalu dilengkapi dengan bubuhan nama terang. Signature itu adalah tanda tangan dari penulisnya. Ya. Yeah, we continue. This is the personal letter body and structure. It's like this for the form. Yeah. Study the part of personal letter form here. There is heading consists of CT and then who sent the letter and then date and then followed by salutation, sender, address, yeah, content. You can look at this picture. Yeah, we continue for the next. Purpose of learning. Sorry, it is lack of O, yeah. Purpose of learning. Yeah, this purpose of learning. After passing the sequences of learning, personal letter, students are supposed to be able to write a simple personal letter as means of written communications to others. Jadi, tujuan pembelajaran personal letter ini antara lain, kalian setelah mempelajari ini diharapkan bisa membuat surat sederhana tentang personal letter itu sendiri yang ditujukan untuk orang lain. Ya, yeah. This is the example of the first thing, heading, ya, yeah. Jakarta. The place, and then January 2, 2021, here is the date, yeah, and year. Dear friend down in Singapore. Jadi ini adalah alamat yang dituju, ya, yeah. Yeah, this is the salutation. Dear Donny, you can remember salutation. And then what is it actually? Here is, what is it? The body of letter. It has been a long time not here. Up to, we count you on there down. Yeah. And then please message me and I will forward with others. Here is hope. That's said to be complimentary hopes. Yeah. And then see you. This is the end of the letter, saying as closing. Yeah. Yeah, ended by sincerely yours. Here says, what is it? You set this one as the complimentary closing, and then signature and name, of course. Yeah. Okay, this is the example of personal letter. You can read it yourself, and then please try to get the difficult words, and then look at the sentence. find out the grammatical structure of this letter. Yeah, we send also the analyzing structure of it. Here is the date. Yeah, just from October 10th, 2020, and then name Anissa and etc. Salutation. You can look at the example just now. Yeah. Okay. Salutation, name of recipient, introduction, body of letter, closure, complimentary closure, signature, and name of the sender. Yeah. Structure of personal letter, student. You have heading, salutation. Please remember and memorize it. When you have a test next time, you will get it too in your exercises. Yeah. Heading, salutation or greeting, and then body of letter, closing or subscription. You can say closing also said to be subscription. Jadi closing bisa juga dikatakan subscription. And then signature, and then added by the name of the sender. Yeah. Remember example here, contoh-contoh yang harus kalian ingat. The deed can be written in full using number and word. Bisa ditulis penuh ya, number, word, jamnya, kapan, bisa, terserah. Bisa ditulis word dengan kata-kata, bisa juga ditulis dengan angka, gitu ya. There are various example of salutation. Ini contoh-contoh salutation. Jadi sapaan dalam surat, contoh-contohnya ini ya. Okay, continue. Language feature in this letter. Personal letter here is having present tense and then using past tense too, and then simple sentence, complex sentence, and compound sentence. Ya. Jadi, we will study about it one by one. Present tense kuwi apa? Past tense apa? Simple sentence apa? Complex sentence juga apa? Compound sentence apa? Dan contohnya yang mana? Begitu ya. Ya, student, here is the decision formula of simple present tense and simple past tense. Yeah, function here to present ideas or information in the present time. Jadi tujuannya kalau penggunaan present tense itu untuk menyampaikan informasi yang terjadi pada hari ini, today, begitu, present time. But simple past to tell about past experience. Yang past tense adalah digunakan untuk menyampaikan pengalaman di masa lampau. And then adverb of time. Usually, commonly, always, generally, every week, every day, once a week, and etc. Ini penanda time signal in the present tense. While this one is time signal for the past tense. Yesterday, a long time ago, last week, in 1919, tahun 2019, 2020, ya misalnya ya, last year, just now, tonight, ya, this morning, itu sudah termasuk simple past tense, ya. Statementnya, sekarang in the pattern sentence of the present tense, you are asked to remember about this one. Don't forget until you are get your work. Yeah, for the English statement here, for the pattern, subject plus verb 1. While in the past, subject plus verb 2. This will be in the verbal sentence. While the nominal 1, no verb. But using auxiliary of the be, was or were in past tense, and then SMR in present tense. Please remember about this. Using question word followed by do or does in the interrogative sentence. In the affirmative, interrogative itu pertanyaan, affirmative adalah
pernyataan atau kalimat berita. Negatif, kalimat negatif. Jadi yang digunakan untuk present tense masih ingat kan ya, do atau does, tergantung subjeknya apa, plusnya verb 1. Untuk negatif ada not-nya menempel di do atau does tersebut. Untuk kalimat tanya, yang menggunakan question word itu setelah question word diikuti oleh auxiliary do atau does di present tense, while di past tense menggunakan did. Sementara pertanyaan affirmative statement, pertanyaan afirmatif yang berupa kalimat tanya tapi jawabnya adalah yes atau no, maka menggunakan do atau does mengawali kalimat tanya. Kemudian di past tense menggunakan did mengawali kalimat tanya, ya. And then negative, not-nya ditempelkan pada do atau does untuk present tense, sementara di past tense not ditempelkan pada did. Can you understand about this? Yeah, we continue for the next slide. We have still many slides here. Compound and complex sentence, darling. Compound sentence, ini kalau di bahasa Indonesia, kalimat majemuk setara. Jadi ada penanda penghubung and, yaitu penambahan, addition ya. But, concession atau pertentangan, or itu adalah option atau pilihan. Two sentences are connected using connectors. Two sentences or more, ya, barangkali lebih bisa. And they result a compound sentence. Mengakibatkan hasilnya adalah kalimat setara, majemuk setara kalau di bahasa Indonesia. While complex sentences, majemuk bertingkat. Here, if you compare the conjunction, it is coordinative conjunction, but in the complex sentence is subordinative conjunction. Coordinative itu menghubungkan setara, subordinative menghubungkan yang tidak sederajat. The example menggunakan ini. Because, so, although, that, if, when, while, and etc. Kalau di sini, and, but, or, nor, ya, itu. Ya, we continue. Compound sentence. For example, I try to speak Spanish and my friend try to speak English. Saya mencoba berbicara bahasa Prancis, sementara teman saya mencoba berbicara bahasa Inggris. Jadi imbang anak-anak, di sini ada subjek, ada predikat, sini juga ada subjek, ada predikat. Kalau objek tidak selalu harus ada, yang jelas penghubung N ini adalah penambahan, begitu. Penjelasan tambahan maksudnya. There is choice is between I'll choose the economic major or I'll cancel the application. Sama, ada dua pilihan. Di antaranya, saya harus memilih ekonomi utama, ekonomi makro, atau saya harus menundanya aplikasi tersebut. Begitu, berarti or itu pilihan. Dua-duanya ada subjek, ada predikat. Di sini juga ada subjek, ada predikat. Berarti menghubungkan dua klausa atau dua hal yang sederajat. Kalau misalnya kata, ya berarti yang dihubungkan kata sederajat. Kalau klausa, ya klausa sederajat. Kalau dia frasa, ya frasa yang sederajat. Begitu. And then complex sentence is compare and different. Ya, when he handed in his homework, he forgot to give the teachers the last page. Ya, ketika dia menangani PR-nya, mengerjakan PR-nya, mengumpulkan PR-nya, maka dia melupakan mengumpulkan halaman yang terakhir. Berarti di sini tidak sederajat anak-anak. When itu menyatakan waktu, ketika, ya. The teacher returned the homework after she noticed the error. Gurunya kemudian mengembalikan PR itu setelah ia mengetahui kesalahan itu. Nah, ini adalah after, setelah, gitu. Kalau tadi with, ketika. The students are studying because they have a test tomorrow. Anak-anak belajar karena mereka akan mendapat ulangan besok. Nah, karena anak-anak di sini menemukan when, after, di situ adalah penjelasan tentang waktu yang dinamakan apa kira-kira? Adverb of time in the complex sentence. Conjunction showing adverb of time for when, after, ya. And then because conjunction showing cause, ya, sebab, ya, atau reason, alasan, begitu. After they finished studying, Juan and Maria went to the movies. Setelah mereka belajar selesai, setelah mereka menyelesaikan belajarnya, Juan dan Maria pergi ke movies. Sama tadi, apa ini? Keterangan waktu. Conjunction showing time. Juan and Maria went to the movies after they finished studying. After, sama di sini posisinya bisa di depan, bisa juga di tengah, ya. Yeah, we continue. Present tense, shouldn't? Just now I said to you like this. Ini adalah kalimat nominal, no verb in on the predicate. Jadi di predikatnya tidak ada kata kerja. Maka dia memakai be yang saya katakan tadi. You are my best friend ever. Ya, ever, never itu adalah adverb of frequency. Ya. Kemudian verbal di sini with verb as the predicate, sebagai predikatnya dia adalah kata kerja. Example, you always understand me. You always understand me. The others won't. Nah, anak-anak won't di sini berarti will not understand. Begitu. Nah, jadi menyatakan the di sini adalah concessive conjunction. Concessive itu apa toh? Pertentangan. Meskipun yang lainnya tidak mau mengerti. Kamu selalu mengerti diriku. Sedangkan yang lain, sementara yang lain, meskipun yang lain tidak mau mengerti. Anak-anak ini lihat ada kata kerja. Lah di sini terkandung kata kerja dia. Won't itu tidak diteruskan sama dengan ini. Jadi won't will not understand. Yang saya merah itu. Ya, kita lanjut. Complex, simple, complex compound sentence. Contoh-contoh seperti ini. Simple sentence, kalimat tunggal anak-anak, sederhana. Di surat tadi, kalian bisa lihat, carilah how about your study. Complex sentence, kalimat majemuk bertingkat di bahasa Indonesia. Contohnya, I do believe the time when we can get together will come soon. Doesn't it? Nah, ini contoh. Kalau ungkapan doesn't it, nanti satu ketika saya jelaskan, ini adalah question text. Pertanyaan berekor yang maksudnya untuk penekanan makna, emphasizing meaning, begitu. Tidak sekarang ya. Nah, when di sini menyatakan apa? Waktu, karena dia majemuk bertingkat tadi. Compound sentence, kalian majemuk setara. Like the example, I miss you so much. I'm always longing to see you. Dihubungkan oleh koma ini, penanda and boleh. Ya. Jadi, I miss you so much and I'm always longing to see you. And boleh, koma juga boleh. Dia setara, anak-anak. Di sini ada I miss you so much. Ada subjek, ada predikat. Belakangnya juga I'm always longing to see you. Ada subjek, ada predikat. Berarti sederajat. Kita teruskan. Anak-anak, at the end, you study about student worksheet. Ya, please do it. Silakan dikerjakan. Ini adalah tugas kalian. Ya, yang nanti bisa dikumpulkan ketika kalian masuk luring pada guru kalian masing-masing. For the 11th grade, IPS 1 with me, Bu Siti Mariam. And then for the IPA 11th grade, to Bu Asih Tri Wulan. Please write down on your notebook. And then, please submit it when you get luring program at your school. Okay? This will be about, please write a simple personal letter to your friends of last SLTP who is studying or working out of
town now. And it is about your holiday in this COVID-19 situation in which you may not go somewhere. Jadi, Anda paham ini? Maksudnya, tulislah sebuah surat pribadi kepada temanmu, teman SMP dulu. Kalau misalnya dibuat tidak punya teman SMP, jelasnya pernah belajar di SMP kan berarti punya ya. Yang mereka sekarang ini sedang belajar atau bekerja di luar kotamu. Kalau kotamu di Prambon ya berarti di luar Prambon. And it is about your holiday dan cerita tentang liburanmu. Kemarin itu liburan semester. Berarti ada planningnya nanti kalau misalnya ndak COVID, aku mau kunjung deh ke kamu, itu berarti bisa future tense. Waktu kininya, kita sekarang ndak bisa kunjung, how are you today? Misalnya seperti itu ya, di surat itu. And then, kalian juga menjelaskan tentang situasi COVID yang tidak diizinkan kemana-mana kepada temanmu itu. Please say your feeling, your experience, ya. Jadi katakan perasaanmu, katakan apa pengalaman pribadimu karena yang kamu hadapi itu. And then second, submit it when you meet your English teacher in Luring program of learning. Jadi kumpulkan tugas itu ketika kamu di dalam program Luring dan bertemu oleh gurumu, begitu ya. Thanks a lot and have a nice day with you. Love you always. Bye bye. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.